Welcome back to AM Live. I have the greatest guy today to work with, Alan Sprinkle.
That depends on the day of the week, though.
Well, today's a good day.
Exactly.
Alan runs a lot of the camera and behind the scenes, the production of our show. He's an amazing movie and game buff. He knows all.
That's
and I learn a lot from him.
Yes.
So what do you want to talk about today?
Actually, today, one of the things, a little background on this. Mm-hmm. Me and a bunch of my friends, we are huge DC Comics buffs. In particular, we love the DC animated stuff. You know, growing up, I love, for me, Saturday morning cartoons.
Sure.
I grew up with stuff like the Batman animated series, the newer version of it. But DC has continued releasing animated films. And one of the things that they've tried to go with is to make them for an older audience.
Right.
So they just released one, which I picked up my copy. I thought it was fantastic. I loved it. Mm-hmm. It's called Justice League: The Flashpoint Paradox.
Okay.
And the basic idea of it is, I know I'm going to butcher the old saying, but the old idea of if you go back in time and kill a mosquito, then that's going to have massive consequences that you can't see.
Right.
That's kind of the idea in this. Mm-hmm. Character goes back in time, changes one thing, but that ripples and that causes massive changes throughout the rest of everything.
Exactly.
Yeah. So everything that we know from the comic book still happens.
Mm-hmm.
It just happens in different ways.
So kind of like a Back to the Future element there.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
So a couple examples that they show right off the bat in this movie when they get to the point where the universe changes, instead of Superman's spaceship crash landing in Kansas,
mm-hmm.
it crash lands in the middle of Metropolis and kills a couple thousand people.
Oh, and that's going to make a huge change on the effect of the future.
It changes everything that happens.
Mm-hmm.
So it turns out to be a very, very cool movie. It's got some interesting ideas in it. Voice acting is awesome. Animation is really nice. And it's got a good segue into the next one that they're going to make. But the one thing that I noticed about this, and I cannot stress this part enough,
mm-hmm.
please read the ratings before you go out and buy a movie.
Tell us why, because I know there's controversy.
This one, when this first came out, when I was reading the reviews for it,
mm-hmm.
one of the issues was you had parents buying it thinking, oh, it's a Superman movie, it's going to be fine,
mm-hmm.
but they didn't read the back of the box where it says PG-13, and I can say this after seeing this myself, this is an exceedingly violent movie at times.
Oh, yeah.
And the last 30 minutes of it
uh-huh.
is this massive war scene between all the superheroes going at each other, ending with a nuke blowing up that wipes out all of humanity.
So they're pushing the PG-13 rating a little farther, huh?
They're really pushing it
yeah.
a little bit. I mean, it's still a very, very good story, just please, I cannot stress this enough, read the rating.
Yes.
If you want a good alternative to this, mm-hmm. where if you want something that's a bit more cartoony,
maybe for younger kids. Yeah,
exactly. Younger kids, they've still got the older Justice League Unlimited show, which has a lot of the same elements. I still love the show.
Mm-hmm.
It's just not as dark. It's not
right.
as violent.
Yeah.
Another good example was after they finished the Batman animated series,
mm-hmm.
they made a TV show called Batman Beyond, which very cool show. It
yeah.
was Batman in the future.
Okay.
Basically, Bruce Wayne is now an older man,
mm-hmm.
and he's training a Batman to replace him.
Okay.
So Bruce Wayne becomes the butler, and now you have this young kid as Batman. So it's like
kind of a spin-off, kind of like Wizard of Oz and Wicked.
Exactly.
Yeah. Okay.
But so Batman Beyond as a show was absolutely fantastic.
Mm-hmm.
They made an hour and a half long movie, which was the first PG-13 that DC Animated made,
mm-hmm.
called Batman Beyond Return of the Joker. Again, read the rating.
Uh-huh.
PG-13, it features a 20-minute flashback where you have Joker systematically kidnap and torture and brainwash Robin.
Oh my gosh.
It is not intended for kids.
Yes, right.
I cannot stress this enough.
It's not for the little guys that want to watch a cartoon.
Exactly. That being said, the Batman Beyond TV series,
mm-hmm.
very, very cool.
Mm-hmm.
And they even have a very nice episode in Justice League Unlimited that kind of brings the two shows together. They did a very cool episode called Epilogue.
That's so neat with the use of creativity to bring these different shows
exactly.
and time together.
And the same goes for video games. I mean, I've got three nephews. My oldest nephew is turning 13 on Sunday. They play their video games.
Yeah.
But when they are with my brother and my sister-in-law, as well as with me, we watch the games that my nephews play.
Right.
They know that when they are with me, they cannot play Grand Theft Auto 4 or Call of Duty.
Uh-huh.
I will not let them do that.
Yeah.
I have plenty of games that they can play,
mm-hmm.
but that's why if you look at any video game box, there's the any video game case, there's the little white box in the lower right corner that says T for teen, E for
mm-hmm.
everybody, M for mature. Then you can flip the game over and look on the backside, and it actually describes it's rated M for mature because it has strong sexual themes,
mm-hmm.
high levels of violence,
right.
alcohol and drug use.
So it sounds like it's really well spelled out. You just have to go to that small effort
yes.
of, you know, it's like reading the label of the grocery store.
Exactly.
You want to know what's in it.
Exactly. I mean, for example, one of my favorite games is a game called Castle Crashers.
Mm-hmm.
It's these little cartoon knights in an old 1990s style smash-em-up game.
Mm-hmm.
I've got a picture of the knights up behind us.
Okay. Oh,
that
yeah,
that
cute.
Is a T-rated game, so
mm-hmm.
that's good for kids between ages 15 and 16 because it does have
teen.
Okay. It has a large level of violence in it.
Mm-hmm.
But you wouldn't know that just by looking at the characters.
Right.
Of course,
exactly.
That being said, to kind of break up the rating stuff, I do have a movie and a game that I will be spending most of my weekend playing.
Really? What is it?
Scott Pilgrim versus the World.
And how's that go? What's the whole storyline to it?
Scott Pilgrim can be summed up in a very simple story. Guy meets girl. Guy falls in love with girl. Guy must defeat girl's 7 evil exes.
Oh, wow. That could be something like Edgar County. That is the entire
movie. It is this nerdy guy, Scott, who has to defeat his girlfriend's 7 evil exes.
Oh,
and they make
goodness.
It like the Legion of Doom. They're all involved with it. But they make a good running joke that she says 7 evil exes,
mm-hmm.
not 7 evil ex-boyfriends.
Uh-huh.
So there's a couple fun little jokes that come into it. The movie was really, really fun.
Mm-hmm.
Super stylized. It was like you were watching a live-action comic book
mm-hmm.
as it was going.
Right.
But they also made a very cool video game tie-in to it, which was based more on the books and less on the movie. But it's the same story, just in a much more cartoony fashion.
Right.
It was, you know, it's kind of like Castle Crashers,
mm-hmm.
except it's more like you're playing through a comic book. So
oh,
it's
neat.
If you have the choice for a younger kid, go with Scott Pilgrim over Castle Crashers because it doesn't have the level of violence that Castle Crashers
did. And where do you normally get your games and videos?
I just go to the local game store up by the Safeway.
Okay.
That's where I go. Otherwise, I do a lot of downloads.
Mm-hmm.
But that being said, so the really big thing I'm just trying to get across is
mm-hmm.
read the ratings and you will be fine.
Do your homework. Look at the box.
Exactly.
Mm-hmm.
You can't look at a box and judge it just from the movie poster
right.
or the picture that's on the front of it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, do a little bit of research and you'll be fine.
Well, thank you so much, Alan.
Yes.
It was a pleasure to talk with you about this fun stuff.
Yes.
We're going to move on over and
going to John.
Going to John.